All 32 NHL teams have now played a game following this first weekend of NHL regular season action. And joining us to give us his studs and duds from the weekend is Evan Kenny. Evan, thanks for being here.
Yeah, Jace, it's my pleasure.
All right, so first of all, Evan, my question is, who are the top performers coming out of this weekend?
Well, Jace, there's definitely a number of them, guys that I definitely left off the list. Just unfortunately had to limit it 2-3 for this opening weekend. Starting things off, I got to go with the great eight, Alex Ovechkin, you know, on his journey to try and beat Wayne Gretzky for the most all-time NHL goals. He got off to a hot start, 3 goals and 2 assists already on the season, with 2 goals and 2 assists coming in the opening game. He now just trails Brett Hull by 8 goals and sits 4th all-time, trailing, as I mentioned, Brett Hull, Yermer Yager, Gordie Howe, and Wayne Gretzky himself. So on that journey, I definitely got to give a nod to Ovi. You know, coming up next on my list is Anze Kopitar, captain for the LA Kings, and really their cornerstone. He proved it, you know, already 7 points in just 2 games, five points in the opening game, including a hat trick, just the 3rd hat trick in franchise history when it comes to opening day games. So he joins Luke Robitaille and Jari Kurri in that aspect. And then as well, he is the oldest player of all time to record 5 points in an opening game. He's 34 years old. He passes the great Phil Esposito, who was 31 years old the last time he scored 5 points in an opening season game. And Jace, my final player here is Connor McDavid. He scores a hat trick in a huge first battle of Alberta. And to me, in, you know, big games, your big players have to come to play. And Connor McDavid really did that for his team.
All right, so speaking of Connor McDavid and that Battle of Alberta, it was nice to have fans back in the stands. I think this was the first Battle of Alberta with fans in the stands since February of 2020. There was a lot of intensity in that game, particularly in that first period. So what did you like from either team in that game?
Yeah, I definitely love that intensity, Jace. You know, from the Calgary Flames, they're a Daryl Sutter coached team. They're going to come out and be a physical, energetic type of team. And I personally love that. You know, they had the lineup to do that. You know, acquiring guys like Zadorov, a big body defenseman who can still move, a number of other guys, Eric Branson being one. I thought he had a very good game for the Flames. So I like to see that intensity and that physicalness from the Flames. 27 hits in this game. I think that we will be seeing that sort of game in, game out from the Calgary Flames. So from the Edmonton Oilers, obviously they were able to pull out the win. And I like the response to that physicality. Zach Cassian, you know, dealing with some concussion issues to start off this season, wasn't necessarily fighting, but he was coming back. He threw 6 hits of his own. You know, that 3rd line of Cassian, Derek Ryan, and Warren Fogle had to really step up for the Oilers in that sense. Derek Ryan also stepping up on the score sheet and getting a goal there to start off the game. And then finally, Jace, what I liked, again, from the Calgary Flames, I think Jacob Markstrom actually played pretty good. I know he did allow 4 goals, 5 with that final empty netter from Connor McDavid, but I know he allowed 5 goals in this game. I think it could have been upwards of 6 or 7 even, you know, if he hadn't made a couple clutch saves. One that really comes to mind was a chance from Leon Draisaitl that he slid across and shut the door there. So I do think I have to give a nod to Jacob Markstrom in this one.
All right, Evan, so in the last minutes here, I'll give you final thoughts. What are your final thoughts heading into the second week of regular season action?
Well, there's a number of questions still up in the air, Jace, you know, and possibly even more questions because of this first week of action. I'm looking for a response from a number of teams, the Winnipeg Jets being one of them. They dropped 2 games to a couple of LA teams in the Anaheim Ducks and the San Jose Sharks. Now, I think the Winnipeg Jets could be a very competitive team, you know, when it comes time to playoffs. This weekend didn't really prove that, so I'm expecting them to bounce back here. As well, the New York Islanders, another team that I expect to be competitive this year, allowed 11 goals in their first 2 games. Now, these New York Islanders teams really pride themselves on their defensive play, so expect them to bounce back. And then finally, speaking about defense, the Buffalo Sabres are the top defensive team in the NHL, which I don't know when the last time anybody heard that was, but it is true, just allowing two goals in two games. So it'll be interesting to see, can this stick, or is it sort of just a first couple game fluke?
Well, thanks so much for taking some time to talk with us today, Evan. I'm excited to see how this season is going to unfold.
Thank you, Jace.